it in the 90s, and...
You can do anything you want. Anything you put your heart and your mind into. I believe that.
It's out, and I said, you know what, I've been reading a lot of scripts with William Morris, and doing a lot of coverage. I want to try writing a script. So I couldn't think of anything else to write about. I'm not an expert in the Army police work, but I am an expert in high school, because I went to high school. So I combined that thing, and I said, it would be interesting if a guy paid off a girl, and then he achieved popularity for that. So that's how it was.
Take your hands off Kenneth, or I'll break your arms.
No!
We were all friends then, remember? And now you want to end his life? Because he's talking to Patty on your side of the cafeteria. Oh man, it's stupid. I know, because that's where I wanted to be. On your side. With your crowd. But I messed up. See, I tried to buy my way in. He's not trying to buy anybody. He's just trying to make friends. Being himself. Cools, nerds, your side, my side. Man, it's all bullshit. It's just tough enough to be yourself.
I haven't seen this movie from start to finish in over 20 years. I guarantee you. And I've never seen this. It's only the second time I've ever seen it. The screening I saw we had on La Brea,
yeah.
If I can remember that right. Yeah, La Brea, the premiere, whatever party we had. And that's the last time I've seen it on the screen. It was the first
time. You obviously don't watch.
Hello, Cindy Mancini. Put on Channel 5!
Well, good after football practice.
You're so lucky.
I missed that hydro massage machine back in the old high school gym.
Well, the old high school misses you too, Bobby Hilton. Good luck with the Hawkeyes.
I think
you can do anything you want. Anything you put your heart and your mind into. I believe that.
It's on all the time.
Yeah, I read that it's one of the highest TV syndicated movies of all time.
And I did a film called Made in Brooklyn a couple of years ago that we're hoping that will be released soon. I'm also a photographer, so I did the still photos on that and was the videographer. I'm doing a film called Exit 102 this August, and we're going to be filming that in Jersey. And I've got two passion projects that I'm working on. One is a charity reality TV show called Race for Humanity, and the other is called You Deserve It, which is a travel show.
First time at the El Royale?
You have the option to stay in either California or Nevada.
Always wanted to craft. I moved to California a month after the riots, which is really fun.
What are you doing out here?
I got a job singing in Reno tomorrow. Don't pay nothing, but a singing.
It's a little too quiet in here. It gives me the willies.
Just too good to be true.
Sir.
Can't take my eyes off you.
We have a problem.
You'd be like heaven to
you watch me?
I only watch who they tell me to watch.
Who's they?
Management.
You think you could just take this mine? I wouldn't come a hug.
No, I figured you would. But I'd be ready when you did.
Are you lost, Father?
Can I confess something to you? I'm not really a priest.
It's a game. It all starts with a simple choice. Would you mind opening the door?
No, I ain't gonna do that.
Which side are you on? Right, wrong? God or no God? Red or black?
I've done horrible things.
So has everybody. Shit happens. Get the whiskey.
You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you.
And we're walking through Bruges and there's a little video store. You know, Blockbusters have 20,000 videos in the store. This had maybe 1,200. And just for the hell of it, I know it sounds pretty bad. I'm in Belgium looking for my movie. But there it was Camp Bobby Love in French, and in a medieval city that was built 1,300 years. It was really weird. That's somebody else.
Funny. Do you want me to give you a ride from after school?
Yes, please. Thank
okay,
you.
Okay,
all right, bye-bye.
Good morning. Well, how was your weekend?
Oh, it was great. How was yours?
Well, Friday, nearly got my face rearranged by a visiting fan trying to save you a seat. And Saturday, you stood aside.
I was doing a TV series in Mexico, and we were all having dinner at this restaurant. And on the TV in the corner, I had my back to it, and some of the cast members and people I was working with said, "Look, there you are, speaking the best Spanish you've ever spoken in your life." But it was Can't Buy Me Love.
Listen, I think that the girls are going to have a little difficulty with that one step,
you know,
that comes with the arms.
I think
up.
We should make it a little harder.
My God, you are stats.
You know what? No, listen, it doesn't matter if they know the whole routine. I mean, we have to look for rhythm.
That's true. I'll get it. Hello, Cindy Mancini. Put on Channel 5, Bobby's on! Thank
you! Are you serious?
And Chris partied with us, he hung out, he drank with us, he partied, we had a great time. Chris comes back to L.A. Chris gets a job in L.A. He gets a job at Disney, and they started a new division at Disney. It's called Acquisitions. Chris Sarkis gets hired as head of acquisitions for Disney. We finish our movie 2 weeks after he gets his job. We show the movie to Chris Sarkis, and Chris Sarkis goes to his two bosses at the time. You might have heard of these two gentlemen, Michael Eisner and Jeffrey Katzenberg. And he went to Eisner and Katzenberg, and he said, "I've got this movie. It's low budget. They made it for nothing. It's a good story. It seems to work. All that kind of stuff." So they were going to screen it for Katzenberg and Eisner. Turns out, my parents were in town visiting, and my brother had tore his knee up playing basketball. He had ACL, so he's on crutches. So I said, "I want to show the movie to my parents and my brother. My parents are here for a week. They want to see." So Disney figured they'd save some money. So they screened it for me, my parents, and my brother. And then I find out 2 minutes before the screening, it's the screening for Eisner and Katzenberg. Okay, there's 10 seats in there. And I said to my parents, I go, "Don't say anything dumb." I told my brother, "Don't say, oh, I love your movies, I'm a big fan." Don't say. I go, "You're going to see a very tall guy walk in and a short guy walk in." And what Steve Rash and Mark Berg and Tom Mount had always said to me, if people laugh in the first 2-3 minutes, you know, we'll get a sale. So it's dark. Thank God that my parents couldn't talk to them. They sit down right in front of us, and I'm like nervous. I don't want to belch. I don't have gas. Nothing. I mean, these are like the kings of Hollywood that are sitting right here. They walk in, they sit down, they laugh 3 or 4 times in the first 3-4 minutes, and they get up and walk out. That day, they bought the film for $6 million.
Wow.
Chuck Lorre. Is that the same Chuck Lorre who created Two and a Half Men?
Yes, Chuck Lorre was a musician back in the day. He's obviously a really talented guy. He created Big Bang Theory, Dharma and Greg, and Two and a Half Men. He's very poor. He has no money, this guy.
Because I remember we did the first set of shooting and then Disney bought it. And then we went back to Tucson, we reshot a bunch of stuff. Yeah. And I think it was when he was like, was it a whole bunch of us sitting in a trailer one day, and Seth had written this letter to Woody Allen. and he was telling all us, because he got radio days. He did radio days right after that, and he had written this long letter about that. And I think because you did Colors, you guys did Colors right after that.
We did three movies in a row.
This is a little cool trivia for you. Courtney and I, before Camp Avila, we were in a movie called Winners Take All.
Motorcycle.
Which you probably haven't seen.
Losers.
Yeah. And then.
Next for July, the biggest deal to ride two wheels. Winners Take All. Featuring world-class supercross champions and the gutsiest cast of pro and stunt riders to ever hit the screen. A great story burning with action.
And then we did Camp Avila, and then after that, we were both reading a script while we were doing Camp Avila, which was Colors.
Yeah, no, I remember, well, you got the script, and he knew that I grew up, you know, in tough neighborhoods in L.A., and, you know, he said, dude, there's a white gangbanger in Colors, you got to get on this. And so that's how we got Camp Avila, since we did this other movie for the Apollo company, and they liked us. Echo Park, Holmes.
Hard bodies together.
That's right.
Tired of youth exploitation films that promise nothing more than cheap thrills? Well, here's the best one yet. Hard Bodies, the story of a boy.
What happened last night? It was like, oh man.
His girl.
You mean you actually went back with Scotty to his dump?
And their up and down romance.
Incredible.
Kaboom! This could be my kind of beach.
Hard Bodies, rated R, coming soon to a theater near you.
Don't tell anybody.
This should cover it.
Saw a crack in the moon last night.
Yeah, me too.
Hey, baby! Come on, let's go!
I gotta go, okay?
It's realism. And so therefore, they're contacting the emotions and the feelings of the true person, so people watching will be able to relate. Yeah, she has to deal with problems of girls my age do. You know, there's a big question mark. And you're wondering, you know, what's going to happen next? What am I doing? And why is this happening as far as virginity and her sexual problems and all that?
Yeah.
See
ya. Bye-bye.
You know, our movie really, you know, it initiates that at first, but it is also carried through the film that shows that, you know, it really came out to be something different. And, you know, it had its advantages, just because I think Cindy was the type of person who probably wouldn't have gotten to know Ronald. Yeah, I think it's definitely prominent, you know, in life, you know, but I also think that it's prominent in high schools, which is really definitely unfortunate. I think that it's too bad that people have to, I mean, I tend to stay away from small groups or cliques just because I think it's really limiting as a person.
Hi, Ronnie.
Your career says you should be popular in order to work again. And also then you're still in school, so you have to deal with the real side of being popular.
Right. I think that, yeah.
R-E-A-L.
Yeah. Yeah. Different. And, you know, I separate both of those lives also because I'm from Colorado, and so I have two different lives, basically.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. It's true. You have to be popular in this business in order to, you know, get work. I mean, that's called being well known. But it's different, you know, when you separate that from life and work.
Mm-hmm.
Work is different because you have to do it in essence.
Thank you.
I tend to be shy with getting to know people. I don't know. But I don't feel it's very important. Well, you should be, you know, nice and kind to people, of course. But I don't feel that it's the most important thing to be popular, because when you feel good about your work, that's what people will look at you for. You know, the audience, the people that are watching, they won't say, oh, she was the funniest too, this guy, Fred, and, you know.
Yes.
So it's different. I think that you should incorporate most of your efforts and most of your time into your work.
Ronald! Okay, let's get this deal straight. One last time. Now, you can have Saturday nights, but only if you ask me to dance.
Okay, I'm asking you in advance. Will you go to the prom with me?
I'm not going to do that stupid dance.
Okay, how about kissing?
Yeah, it's important.
That's a must.
Definitely.
And Bobby Love.
Do you have any plans on Friday night?
Well, do you plan everything?
Always.
Want to spend the night with Julia Roberts?
Let's watch old movies all night. We'll just veg out in front of the TV.
WKSN, the movie that made her a star.
End of the original script, Richard's character threw my character out of the car, threw the money on top of her, and drove away, and the credits rolled.
How can you say no to a face like that?
Mercy.
Pretty Woman, Friday at 7.
I can do anything I want to, baby. I am lost.
So plenty. I love you. You belong to me.
No. People don't belong to people.
Of course they do.
I'm not going to let anyone put me in a cage.
I don't want to put you in a cage. I want to love you.
The same thing.
You know what's wrong with you, Miss Whoever you are? You're chicken. You've got no guts. You're afraid to stick out your chin and say, okay, life's a fact. People do fall in love. People do belong to each other. Because that's the only chance anybody's got for real happiness. You call yourself a free spirit, a wild thing. And you're terrified somebody's going to stick you in a cage. Well, baby, you're already in that cage. You built it yourself. And it's not bounded in the west by Tulip, Texas, or in the east by Somaliland. It's wherever you go. Because no matter where you run, you just end up running into yourself. Here, I've been carrying this thing around for months. I don't want it anymore.
Yes, thank you for asking. www.darcydemoss.com. That's DarcyDemoss.com. Darcy. Awesome.